I'm Nash Weather Service Phoenix meteorologist Jared Haya with a drought update. We're going to take a look at some of the recent precipitation, how that's affected the drought, some of the good and bad news that goes along with what we are facing here with the long-term drought across the Southwest. Let's start with some good signs. If you've been out and about, if you've looked at Camelback or South Mountain or Papago Park, you might have noticed a little bit of a green tint to the ground, without question. Take a look at this picture, very close to Holland Rock with the saguaros and that bed of grass and weeds in the foreground. This was taken yesterday. No question, soil moisture is up. You can even kind of see it if you're walking around some of our area parks. The ground is almost kind of sticky or muddy looking because of the rains that we've seen recently. And of course, that is some excellent news. Let's take a look at some of the key points here. Since October 1st, precipitation totals across Arizona have been above normal. 4 inches of rain has fallen since October 1st at Phoenix. Why do we go back to October 1st? Well, that's when the water year calculations began here in the Southwest. That's 160% of normal. Flagstaff is also at 160% of normal on its snow liquid water equivalent. That's if you were to melt all of the snow and then add in the rain that's fallen since October 1st. 84.5 inches of snow has fallen up there, and that's very close to their typical seasonal average for the entire winter, which is around 90 inches. So this is all great news. The short-term drought, thus, has improved substantially. Keyword there, short term. Well, I guess that's two words, short term drought. The long term drought is still an issue. And again, we'll dive into that more in a second. Percent of normal precipitation. So this map is a little hard to see, but you can definitely notice some of those shades of blue and purple taking over a larger chunk of the state of Arizona there, especially parts of Pinal County, Mojave County, La Paz County as well, and Yavapai County. Gila County, several counties there, seeing the above normal precipitation, sharing in on that since the beginning of the water year in October. So how has that affected the short-term drought? Well, notice last June, Phoenix was in a severe drought, and areas up toward Lake Mead were in an exceptional drought. Fast forward to now, drought status has been removed from much of the state. Abnormally dry conditions persist in western Maricopa County, and a moderate drought continues along the Colorado River and north toward the Grand Canyon and also south and southeast of Tucson. This is a drastic improvement in a relatively short amount of time. Implications of that short-term drought improvement? Situations like this. This is the Salt River system. So about a year ago, the Salt River system, which is Roosevelt, Apache Canyon, Saguaro Lake, as well as Bartlett and Horseshoe Lakes, is around 71% of full capacity. This year, at this time, we're at 78%. Doesn't seem like a lot, but that's actually a really, really good sign for us heading into what's going to be our drier months. But we also have snow that's yet to melt in the Salt River system. Now take a look at this. This is the map of the Southwest, showing the snow water equivalent as of January 23rd. And that entire area shaded in blue, that's in excess of 150% of the 30-year average in terms of the amount of snow liquid equivalent. So that's if we were to melt all the snow, how much of it compared to normal is currently sitting up that way. And this is, again, a good sign, no question about it. Now we kind of turn to the bad thing, which is the long-term drought. This has taken, as you know, 2 decades to really become an issue. It's not going to be fixed in one season. You're well aware, I'm sure, of the atmospheric river event. Some call it the Pineapple Express. There have been several of those, in fact, that have hit California over the last month and has dumped a lot of snow and a lot of rain in a short amount of time. It's caused some weather-related hazards from flooding, mudslides, things of that nature, and travel conditions that have been really tough. But it's also helped some of the lake and reservoir levels across parts of California. But for the Colorado River system to really get replenished in a substantial way, we're going to have to see some of those inland areas like parts of Utah, Nevada, northern Arizona, sections of Colorado, especially the headwaters of the river, see a lot more precipitation like this over several years. And so here's what we have right now. Like Lake Mead, it's still way down, 28%. Now that level should climb a little bit as we see the snow melt in the spring, but still, this is a huge hole to climb out of. Lake Powell, 24% of capacity. Some of the upstream smaller reservoirs, you can see anywhere from 30 to 60% capacity. So yeah, we've got a lot of work to do here. Again, this is a long-term challenge. And what we mean by that is the changing climate, the warming summers, all of these playing a role, including even in the wintertime with the warmer temperatures causing higher snow levels. You're not piling up that snow, even when you're having these weather systems that will melt off more efficiently in the spring. And so that's some of the challenge that we're facing to really replenish the Colorado Basin. But again, we've got some good news. We're going to be happy about that in the short run, that our local river system, the Salt River system, is doing fairly well, but we get a lot of cap water here in the desert southwest through Arizona, and that's served from the Colorado Basin, and the Colorado Basin still continues to face quite a few challenges. As we look ahead here, and this is the next 2-week period, we do expect a little weather system to come through Monday and Tuesday. We could see a quarter to three quarters of an inch of rain with that. Nothing overly extensive. But as we head toward the week two time frame, we do see favored odds for below normal precipitation. And unfortunately, that is the trend continuing February, March, April into the spring, about a 40% chance to a 50% chance leaning toward below normal precipitation across the Southwest. So we still have a chance to get a little more of that winter Pacific moisture in here before things start to change and the jet stream relaxes and heads a little farther north. One thing's for sure, this La Nina has been different than those in the past in that we have seen that really, really strong Pacific jet pulling in that moisture into the Southwest and helping our drought in the short run. But as we've mentioned many, many times, it's going to take several winters and summers, of course, of rain to really, really get rid of that long-term drought. We'll keep you posted right here at the NWS Phoenix. In the meantime, thanks for stopping by.